Good morning. Today I'm going to have a go at using some stamps that I have to actually heat foil with my Go Press and foil. So I bought these little cupcake stamps recently in Action, and they came with a die as well to cut this particular one out, which was, and they were only about, I don't know, less than €3, probably not even €2. So very reasonable. Now, I haven't stamped in a long while. It used to be my favourite craft, I have to admit, stamping, because I am come from, I suppose I started crafting probably 16 or 17 years ago, and really in those days there wasn't much else to do other than stamping. So I have a load of stamps, but I very rarely, in fact this is the first time I've stamped full, in probably 10 or 12 years. So I don't have a spraunchy stamping mat like most people do have. And all my product is actually pretty much old. I've got the Heat It Up embossing powder. I've got a very ancient Versamark ink pad. And you can see what state the ink pad is in. It's so old. But it's still tacky, so never mind. And I have a block that I have put three of the stamps on. Okay, so they're more difficult to see because they're obviously clear. Now I'm going to do this onto black card because I think it's probably going to be easier to see on black than it is on the white. And the first thing I'm going to do is, because I have no idea where my actual anti-static mat is, I have got some talcum for baby powder in this piece of paper here. So I'm just going to cover this card in baby powder, which will obviously wipe off afterwards, but so just to get rid of any finger marks that I might have on it, and then just give it a quick, because I don't want it all over it, and it will brush off later. I'm hoping. That's the theory. Anyway, that is what I'm reckoning. And so my first thing to do is to stamp. Oh, the first thing I do, actually, before I do anything else, I have put my Go Press and foil on to heat, because that takes a little while to heat up. In actual fact, that is already green. However, I know that it will need a considerable amount of heat to set the actual heat foil, hot foils. So that is on heating up. I have got a piece of 260 GSM card that I've folded in half, and I'm going to use this as a shim. And my reasoning for using this as a shim is that I'm going to put the whole plate through my Big Shot machine or whatever wide mouth die cutting machine you actually have is useful. So I'm just going to put you on pause for a second. So I'm going to now tap my Versamark onto my stamps. And it's actually not the Versamark. In fact, you could probably use any ink. I did use stays on, that doesn't work, but I'm sure you, because that obviously dries too quickly. So you need to drink an ink that doesn't dry too quickly. And I don't know quite why I'm putting so much Versamark on. There's absolutely no necessity other than I'm sat there talking. So I have my stamped up. And what I'm going to use is, I don't have a fancy stamping mat, and I understand you nowadays you're meant to actually stamp onto something soft. So I don't know if these are squidgy mats or what they call them, magnetic mats from my craftware machine. But at least it has a little bit of give than other than not. So I'm going to start off with that just in the middle and stamp it on. Now, as I say, it's an age since I've done stamping, so please forgive me if I make a mess of stamping, because I'm not a stamper any longer. Oh, that seems to have come out okay. So I'm just going to then put a few more randomly. So to stamp that up again. I'm going to stamp at an angle. No, I'm going to stamp at a different angle this way. I'm going to stamp that one there and that one there. The good news is that you can actually see what you're doing with a clear block, which I'm from the days where we had lovely wooden blocks, and most of my stamps are wooden mounted stamps. So that's how old my stamping goes back to, but it matters not. So I'm going to go, doesn't even matter if it's not the right way around, I don't think. I'm going to put that one there, stamping off the page, and a bit of that one there, because it's still be tacky. Okay, so my reason for using black card was that you can actually see the stamped images with the VersaMark. Okay, so that's that done for now. No longer need that, no longer need that. I will clean my stamp later, I promise you. So now, out of that, I need a piece of paper to put my card into, and any old piece of paper will do. And I'm just going to sprinkle that over with my silk. This is actually called silver foot pearl, but I don't think it matters what colour you use, as long as it's... I did try yesterday to do this with... Oh, excuse me, that's my donkey. I don't know if you can hear him shouting his head off. I did try yesterday using this with... doing this system with some... ultra thick. Sorry, I was just having a moment then, completely forgot what it was called, ultra thick. But I'm not sure whether my product was just too old or whether it's always like that, but it was very granular and it didn't really stick. I'll show you an example later of what I did, but it didn't really adhere to the actual embossing powder. So now you can see I've got a nice, oops, try not to do the bit I've got. It's a little bit of a random pattern there, not particular, not very artistic, but it's just for the information. Now, I have no idea what happened to my lovely tweezers. I've got some lovely tweezers and I haven't a clue what I've done with them, so I'm just going to hold this with a peg to heat set it, because it is the actual heat setting of the embossing powder that is the key to this whole exercise. So, and also while I do that, I'm going to put my shim onto my plate to start that warming up. So it's nice and warm when I put the actual card inside it. Okay, so that's warming up. Sorry you can't see that, but if you've got a GoPress and foil, then you know what it looks like. So I don't know how far this is. Might come over. Yes, it will come over. So, oops, helps. Always a good idea to plug your machines in. Always works better that way. Out of there, put that in there, switch on, oops, sorry about that. So, as I say, things work better when they're plugged in. Now for this time, I'm going to heat from behind. I think it matters not whether you heat on top or behind. I'm just like to come in from behind with this, because I think it's going to blow less powder away. I don't know. Please correct me if I'm wrong, because as I say, I no longer am a stamper. So I'm just setting the powder. And as you can see, I love it when it turns. It's really gorgeous when it turns. It's quite fun. Now I remember why I used to like stamping. It's watching the powder go from whatever colour to whatever colour and shine coming on it. So, there we go. So to me that looks like it's all done. That's all nicely done. oops, as you can see, all nice and sheeny shiny. So that looks nice as it is, but we want to go one step further. Now, I don't know if it's a good idea at this stage to brush off the excess powder or not. Let's have a little look. Okay, so that's because we don't want the foil sticking to that either. So, easily brushed off with a big brush. Now, I need some foil. So, I'm actually only going to foil half of this today, at this stage, because we can go back and foil a bit more later and just see what happens. So, I've got some foil here, which is actually has been hanging around on my desk and it's got scratched, etc. So there's bits of it missing. So it's probably not the best example to use, but I'm going to use it anyway. So I'm going to take my foil and I'm going to do, what am I going to do? I'm going to do, just that bit down there for now. So I don't, actually I'm going to cut that off there. Let's see where that covers. How much does that cover of that? Let's just do the middle. So, if you remember with our go press and foil, I'm going to do that bottom bit there. We always have the shiny part looking towards the either the base of the plate, or actually we need it to be as we would want to see it on the card. So we wouldn't actually want to see that side on our card surface, the dull side. We wouldn't want that on our card surface because it would be very, we want to see that colour there. So I'm going to pop that on there. I'm going to just put this in my folder, which is just, as I say, 260 GSM folded in half. And the reason I'm only going to do a half of this card at the moment is so that you can actually see the before and after, which hopefully there will be a full before and after. I'm also, I know I've got it that way round, so I'm going to turn it so that when I put it on the go press, the actual shiny side is down on the heat plate, towards the heat plate. And that is very important. Whenever you're foiling, make sure you've got the shiny side, the proper side, the side you want to see on your card, on the foil plate. And I'm going to leave that to heat up. Now my foil, my hot place is nice and hot. It's actually on red at the moment. So I'm going to wait for that to come up to temperature. Because it might take a few moments more to come up to temperature, because when I plugged my little pink pig, which you can actually see how long I've been actually doing craft for, because this is a pink pig that was sold on Crate and Craft years and years and years ago. It's made by Johnson. And I don't even know if it's still available, but it has been a great workhorse for me. And a heating gun. So we don't need anything else. Now this is just flashing, so I'm gonna wait for that to actually come back up to heat again. And we're gonna see what happens. So talk amongst yourselves. Actually, I'll put you on pause while that actually heats up. That would be the best thing. Okay, so that has come back up to green, and I've actually let it go through green, go off onto red and go onto green again, because I really want it to be warm, because that's the whole thing, it's the heat, it's heating up that embossing powder again. Now I'm going to go very, very slowly through my Big Shot, and I'm only going to go through once to begin with. I can go through once. If it hasn't done what I want it to do, then I can actually put it through again. But if I put it through twice to begin with and it overfoils, I've actually lost all the work I've done. So I might as well just be careful and put it through once. So as you'll see, I've put the sandwich complete shut through my go press. So you need, with a go press and foil, you need to have a wide mouthed machine. You can't use anything like the, I believe you can't use the Gemini press because it's actually too small a mouth for that to go through. So it has to be able to take your old style dies. And always, always get into the habit when you've rolled anything through, albeit die cutting or whatever, put your plate, your sandwich, back onto your machine, because then it's warming up in readiness for your next project or whatever you need to do next. So it's always a good tip to do that. So now is the moment of truth. I've taken this off the go press and we're going to see if it's actually been sufficient to go through. So that is upside down. So, I'm not sure if it needs one more go or not. However, I can actually see, I don't know if you can see that there. You can just make out that where the, you can see those dots. Maybe if I come further back, you can see it better. You can see there's a slight outline of the actual cupcakes. So let me just see, has this adhered? Yes, it has, but I think it could do maybe a second go through because this is maybe slightly less than 260 GSM, the black card, and all card actually takes foiling differently. I don't know if this black card, I've actually never foiled onto this black card, so I don't know if this black card will actually take the foil as well as maybe, I generally tend to use super smooth white card, and I know that that actually, the foil always sticks absolutely perfectly to that. So I don't know, I'm not sure if that black card actually, because it's the first time I've ever tried foiling onto black card, I don't know if the foil will adhere as well to that or not. So I'm just going to leave that for a couple of seconds to warm up again. Let's have another go. It's just come back up to green. I'm taking it off the cradle and putting it back through my Big Shot, Sizzix Big Shot. Don't forget to roll very, very slowly because we need to get that foil to adhere to the actual heated part of the embossing powder. And if we don't roll it slowly, it's just going to, well, it's not going to stick full stop. So I've rolled it through as far as I know, and I'm going to roll it back. So I'm going to roll it a second time this time and see if it's any different or not this time. But if you go back to when we used to use a laminator to foil machines with cold foil, if you think how long the laminator took to actually take your piece of paper into the machine. So this is why it has to be slow and steady. And also, actually, I haven't over-shimmed this, because if you over-shim it, you could tend to actually get transfer of tape of the foil onto pieces you don't want. So it's better to under-shim the first time than to go too high. You can always add a shim. You can't always take one away. So here is the moment of truth again. So let's see, does that look any different? No, I don't think it does. It looks very similar. So, but let's see. So let's take this off. And yes, you can actually see from the foil that there is, oops, it's very difficult, there is daylight coming through the foil. So you have put some foil down, and actually that's really quite nice. It's very delicate. I don't know if you can actually see that on which is why I did it. I think at that angle you can see it, yes. See, because you can see this side has not been foiled, and only from there downwards, so only a little bit of this cupcake here has been foiled, and the others have. So it's very, very delicate. Absolutely. And I think that looks rather beautiful because it's very, as I say, very delicate. A bit like me, not. So here we have now another use for our, excuse me, we can get all our stamps out and we can foil our stamps using Versamark and probably if I had some actual more up-to-date embossing powder, I might actually even go and treat myself to a pot of clear embossing powder, because it doesn't have to be a particular colour. But yes, you can see that, that's shining quite nicely. So I think I'm actually going to do the other half of this with some gold and see what happens with that. So I should put you on pause while I cut the gold. By the way, if ever you have a problem cutting your foil, as I do, I realise that my scissors, if I use them this way to cut foil, they don't cut very well. Whereas if I use them this way, they don't actually make a jaggy edge on the foil. So sometimes turn your scissors over if you're getting a sort of scratchy mark like this. When I first started to cut that, try turning your scissors over. It might just be your scissors and not operator error as such. Right, that's just heating up. So while that's heating up, I just wanted to show you some absolute bargain finds I've had recently in a company called Action. And now I live in France. I don't know if you get Action in the UK, but these stamps, I've got three lovely feather stamps and also a die to cut them out, or to cut one of them out in particular. I think this one only cuts this one out. But they were only about, this was only $2.99. I don't think it was even $2.99. As I said, with the cupcakes, it was really, really cheap. And they do all sorts of things. They do embossing folders with a hole in the middle. And then you've got some stamps. You've got an alphabetical stamp, in this case, a vintage stamp, and a cog. So you can put whatever you like in the middle. You don't even have to put these. You can put another type of stamp in the middle there if you wish. Again, under €3, a nice one with another square in the middle. And Be Mine, a watering can and some roses. You can see those. Really, really reasonable. Hearts with love, I love you, and a little heart, which is quite nice. So those are those. And what I really, really, really love, really, really, really love, are cutting and embossing folders. Now, I've never seen these before, and put this out of here. It's an embossing folder, but inside the embossing folder, this is just little flowers, and I'll demonstrate this another day. But when you open it up, you can see it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 little dies in there. So when you actually put your paper in, close it down, run it through your die cutting machine, you get a nice embossed impression, but also you get these little flowers here cut out. So you've actually got some cutouts on your, and I've never seen cutting and embossing folders before. And they are so, these again, under €3. A couple of pounds for an embossing folder and die cutting. Absolutely perfect. Right, I digress with that, but I just thought I'd like to share things with people. So this is nice and hot again, so I'm going to take it out again. Now this time I'm going to run it through twice. Slowly, 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 catchy monkey. Or, I don't know why we say that. Why would we want to catch a monkey? Obviously we used to in previous days. But I don't think there's any monkeys in France that I can actually catch, so that's good. So, excuse the fact that you've never got my head, but that's probably a good thing as well. So, as you can see, I'm going painfully slowly through. And you will actually think nothing is happening, but I'm sure if I was to actually put another shim in and go through, there would be an actual fact, it would lay down too much foil and it would foil the background. We will try that in a minute, so we'll see what happens. Back on the bait, take my folder out. Another reason I use a folder, well, it's a piece of cardboard, it's a technical term for a piece of card folded in half, is that if you were to have two shims, no problem, you can do. But when it's a folder, it's easier to keep everything together and you've not got the worry of two pieces of card slipping when you put it down or pick it up. So let's have a little look to see what's gone on here. So yes, I can see that we've got some foiling going on there. I'm not sure that that's... Now, that hasn't completely covered this area here, so I can see that there's a bit missing there. So I'm actually going to put that through again, and I'm going to turn it round. I'm going to turn it around that way and just heat it up again. I might actually put a little bit of another shim just in that corner, because that doesn't seem to have, done as well. So I've got a piece of card here. And I'm just going to cut a piece off like that. So this is what I say. If you do it once and it's not adhered, not a problem. You go through and do it again. Whereas if you go for it first time and put it through twice or with extra shims, you might not be quite so lucky. And you were, especially if you've got some nice card. At the moment, I'm only using black card stock, which is not a very good quality. And some old foil, so that really doesn't matter. But if you were actually using a nice piece of card, you'd be really upset with yourself if you actually spoilt it for the sake of doing it through the machine twice. So I'll just pop you on pause again while that warms up. Okay, that's warmed up again now. Take my plate out again, pop it in there, and don't forget, very, very, very slowly. Absolutely glorious day here today. I should be outside gardening, but no, I'm in here because I like playing with my machines as well, and I don't very often get a big opportunity to do it because I'm always working, so best of both worlds. So I put that through once more, and just once more, and let's have a look and see how that fared. In actual fact, let's take my extra shim. Now you can see with that extra shim, it seems to have made an awful lot of difference, which is why I say you can add a shim, but you can't actually take it away. And that is going to look like it's going to be even better. So I'm going to leave that little bit in there. Keep that safe, because obviously we don't need to waste that. And I'm going to just peel this back slowly. Well, if I could actually get hold of the edge. So there we go. So that has done very nicely. So I just foiled the rest of that little cupcake, this one, because I hadn't actually done it before. I'd only done about that much of it. So let's see what happens with the gold. Too much of a shim. So I should have actually stuck with my original instinct. As you can see, it's foiled it nicely, but you've got over foiling here. And that is probably where I went through twice to begin with. So I shouldn't have gone through twice. As I said, you can go through once, but if you go through twice, you risk doing that, which is a shame because it has taken the foil. But I think that's because I went through twice and not once. But you get the gist of it. You just have to play around with it until you find what is best for you, and more importantly, what is best for your machine. But it's nice to show that you can make mistakes as well. But, so instead of using this as a background, as I've made a bit of a mistake here, what I can do is just pop that into my scan and cut and scan it in and cut them all out. So I can use them as individual pieces, or I could just cut off here, maybe just cut down there. And make that into a square card, so I could because it doesn't hurt to have a piece hanging off the edge, so that could be a square card. So I am actually very happy with that result, even though I did that. Thought, as I'd shown it to you, you might like to see how this actually works, the little die cutting folder. So I'm going to use just my base plate. Oops, I don't know what that is on there, something on there. And my cutting mat, my folder with my piece of card in, and my other cutting mat on top. Although I use, say they're cutting mats, I don't actually use the top one as a cutting mat because I don't like getting it spoiled. So I actually cut up an old self-heating mat. And I find that if I cut into the self-heating mat, if I'm using a die, even my most, I've got one die that is an absolutely notorious die for not cutting. I've never been able to get it to cut properly. It doesn't matter how many times and positions I've turned it and put it round. But using this with the die facing up into this rather than facing down into it, so this is actually on the top, I find even my most difficult die I can cut with one pass. So let's have a go and see how this goes. I've not cut this one out, so I'm hoping it's a good sandwich. Yes, it's going through. It's quite a little bit stiff, but it's not too bad. So that's gone through. And I'm just going to try it with one pass. And then, oops, I've got big plates here. So let's have a look and see what's happened. See, did that actually come out nicely? So I'm going to try and keep that in place. And it looks like it's cut it perfectly. Yes, as you can see, take it out of there. So, there's my little pokey tool on, there it is. I probably could have put this through twice. It's a little bit difficult to get out the hearts. But actually, that actually wouldn't be a bad thing, even. If you had only put it through once, actual fact, that would be quite nice. To actually pop those through so that they're sticking up. So only half cut them. What a good idea. So as you can see, those ones have all cut out, but those ones you could put a nice different coloured layer underneath. I've just got red at the moment, it doesn't really matter. And you could see that you could actually stand those up. And wouldn't that look quite pretty, actually, not even cut out. But that's how it is cut out. So I don't know if these ones have cut out. Yes, these ones have all cut out. And that was on one pass. So maybe it would be better to do two passes. But actually, that looks quite sweet. Oops, there's another two there. So that's not cut out properly. So again, we could stand those ones up. Or I can just put this back into the machine, into the folder. And pop it through again. So let's see. There it is. I bet I don't get it back in exactly the right place. I hope I do. Let's just have a quick squeeze. So pop that on there. Put that in a different way this time. Just reverse, change the angle slightly. Maybe I should have had the actual adapter plate B in place. So let's just see what happens there. Backwards. I don't know if I've got the last flower out then. Let me see what has happened. I've slightly overcut, but that is absolutely fine. Now, I wonder, will it take the actual B plate in there, as it says it should. I just didn't want to crank it up too high and break my new folder. So, oh no, it does go through, so probably Sizzix do know what they're talking about. So yes, Sizzix do know the score. And also, if you were to put a squidgy mat on top of that, you probably would also get a nice, much deeper emboss. So, there we go. Very crisp for a cheap embossing folder. Look, all the bits have come out. And that is perfect. And I think I've just about had that timed as well, because my battery sounds like it's actually coming out. It's actually not so easy to see white on black and white. Black and white, you can see. Very pretty, very, very pretty. And these, as I say, are only silly money. So I hope you enjoyed that. Hope I haven't garbled on for too long. And I'll see you again another time. Bye for now.